Hello, mate. Racist Rick here. I don't like getting messages from anyone with anything beyond a nice whitey skin, whitey, paler than white, milky whiteness. It's all about the Nazis. Personally, I joined the Nazis about 10 years ago. We have a meeting every weekend. We're just regular blokes. We just have a laugh. Yeah, everybody tries to demonise us. I mean, somebody told me, for example, that a few years ago when I was a teenager, when me mate Pakistani mate was talking to me wife, apparently I called him up, called him a cunt and a paki, but you know, he didn't mind. He knows what I'm like, you know, so he forgave me. We had a pint and a laugh about it. What do you mean? I think threatened his family. Oh, yeah, well, we always got to do that, haven't you? Oh, I threatened and stabbed him and all. Oh, yeah, you got to do all that. You got to go to full hog. Be a right cunt when you do it. But afterwards, we was all right because we had a nice pint. So who gives a fuck?
Hello, thank you. Turn that bar, please.
All right, yeah, racist one there. Doing a bit of the old third umpiring with the umpire downstairs. So let's have a look at this.
Yes, sir. The ball seems to be clipping the bell. The bell is moving and it come off. And can we have ultrasound, please? Ultrasound. And the click one, you know, when we can see the ball clicking it. Can we have a look at that, please? Very good. Roll it. Yes, ball looking like hitting the bell. Bell looking like it coming off. Bell looking like it hitting floor. Batsman looking like he wants to walk to pavilion and thinks he's out. Oh, but at the same moment, there's another thing as well.
What's that then? What's that?
Well, there seems to be a bit of wind, you know. We're playing in Christchurch, New Zealand, and bloody Christ, you know. Oh, my God. Bloody Christ. Over here, the wind can do a lot of things. I remember there's a principle that sometimes if the wind is blowing and the bale can be pushed by the wind, and that is the real factor of the bale being dislodged rather than the ball hitting. So I think we have benefit of doubt, and please signal to the umpire to reverse your decision to call the Indian batsman Guntappa Vishwanath back, and resumption of play should resume, please. I think it is the wind.
What are you talking about, mate?
But W.G. Grace did the same thing in a match. He said, oh, bloody, God, blimey, windy today. I think it's windy. I'm sorry, but I have to give the benefit of the doubt due to the inclement weather.
You fucking cunt.
Oh, no. Fine, match referee will have to fine you for that one.
Now look over here at me. I've been a commentator for cricket for long, long times, man. And everybody always asking about the high tea ball time question. At what point did Boateng stop going from being a legend and a myth in the world of cricket to just an average mortal man? And in my opinion, is when Ian Boateng took on Tim Hodgson as his agent in 1985, man. And the exact moment, I can even tell you, boy, I can tell you, is when he started to wear those funny clothes and he dyes his hair blonde, man. A blonde Ian Boateng. What the hell are you thinking about, man? Ian Boateng got short brown hair and he's a little pudgy, but he's quite strong, man. And they used to call him Guy the Gorilla. But then in 1985, man, he exchanged the passion for the glory. Do you understand, man? The passion exchanged for the glory. And at that moment, he's not the same player, man. And the moment Boateng starts celebrating himself, ironically, that's when Boateng come down off his peak, man. Boateng's peak from 81. 77 to 81, Boateng, man. You can't touch him, man. You can't touch the Boateng. You're a great player then. And then, okay, they give him the captaincy and that affect his confidence. But no problem, man, because the miracle of 81 is just around the corner. And then, but after that thing, not the same, man. I think he just got too. I think what happened, his satisfaction level, yeah? His satisfaction quota. His quota of satisfaction. Got satisfied in that 1981, the miracle. I call that year the miracle. People talk about the royal wedding 1985, the Brixton riot. I go, no, man, there was only one riot in 1981, and that riot be on the cricket pitch, man. But then after that, man, Boateng not the same. 82, what happened? I don't hear nothing about Boateng. 1983, that World Cup, man. The World Cup, man. The whole world is there. The Cup, man. Playing the cricket. And who win? Fucking India. How India going to win that World Cup, man? Charas, man. Don't make no sense. The 84, we had the black wash. We don't hear about Botham then. In 85, that bastard Tim Hudson come and he take away Botham. Botham still had time there to be a passion man, passion cricket player. And you know what miracle? We could have the miracle of 1986. We could have had. But in 86, what happened? Botham going down, man, for marijuana possession. Man, marijuana, way of life in Jamaica and West Indies. It's a way of life. But, man, it's just like that's a tragedy, man. They call about the glory of Botham. Yeah, there's a glory, but man, in my heart, there are we going to be a tragedy with Botham associated with the years preceding because it was a slow descent, man. 82 to 92, it's a slow, it's a long way down from the top, man. A long, long way, man.
Okay, there's been an appeal for court behind. There's been a court for appeal for behind. And we have a guest referee to help on the panel. And it is the phantom of the deceased Richie Beno as a guest referee from the other side. Richie Beno, please, could you take a look at this?
Thank you, Mr. Venkatarathan. So we're going to ask to see if we could get a slow motion review of that one, please. Thank you. Oh, it is not a G, but not at all. No, sorry, we couldn't get him. It's me, it's Bill Lowry. Ha ha ha, Bill Lowry, yeah, it's me. Anyway, so let's have a look at that. Let's look at a snicko. Let's see about the snicko first. Yeah, it looks like a definite snick going past the edge of the bat of Ranatunga. The ball goes behind to the wicketkeeper who takes a dive. Now, I'm not sure if it's straight into the gloves. It looks like it's in the gloves. There's no bounce or whatever. And what do you think about that?
Well, I don't really know, but it looks like I give batsman benefit of the doubt. I know it is very fast bowling by Glenn McGrath, but I will give benefit of doubt.
Well, it does look like it's cleanly taken there, umpire Venkatarathan.
I know, but I'm traditionist. If you don't have 100% proof,
yeah, I understand what you mean. I mean, back in the days, we never had all this malarkey of third umpires and stuff. I mean, the umpire was like a god out there on the green. He was like a god. Well, and his decision stood. What's the point about an umpire if he could be overruled? There's no, there's no respect for that there. I mean, are you saying it's not out, despite the fact that it looks like it's out? Yeah, benefit of doubt. Umpire, please reverse your decision and tell the umpire to stand his, tell the batsman, sorry, to stand his ground and it is not out. I repeat, not out.
Well, I have to admit, after all my years watching cricket, I've never seen anything quite like the 100. And this is me, Richie Beno, speaking. Absolutely incredible. Test cricket was great, but it's nothing put next to the 100. I am inclined to agree, Richie. Yes, you do indeed, Richie. I'm afraid. That's me. You don't get your own bloody name wrong, mate, but I'm going to say, my day, we weren't half as talented as these boys out there. I mean, I'm blind during the 100. I can't believe it. Can't believe my eyes. Back in my day, we didn't have the skills they do now. The 100's just incredible.
Absolutely incredible it is indeed. You took the words out of my mouth. One day cricket, test cricket, T20, who cares? It's all absolutely diabolical put next to the 100. Let's all stand together in unison. Black Lives Matter, and so does the 100.
It certainly does. Black Lives Matter, from me, Fred Truman. Bye.
You walked in the cold air. Freezing breath of the window till lying waiting. The feeling is gone between you and I. It means nothing to me.